I'm asking everybody to mute, please. Okay, good afternoon and welcome to Made in New Jersey TV and Film Commission. We are so lucky to have Joe Marra here, who said yes without even knowing how much work was involved. He's been with the New Jersey Motion Picture and TV Commission for over 9 years, and he is currently what's your title, Joe?
Production coordinator.
Production coordinator. And we are very much looking forward to hearing from him tonight. Take it away, Joe.
Thank you very much. Thanks so much for joining us on this beautiful night. So we're here to talk about the movies. And as a way of introduction, because I'm not sure if some of you are aware of the New Jersey Film Commission and what we do, I put together a little bit of a video. So I'm going to show that now. Plays. Oh, well, this is embarrassing.
Not embarrassing. It happens to everyone.
Yeah, okay.
You want to tell us what we're going to see?
Sure, yeah. So this is a little bit of an introductory video to the Film Commission and the stuff that we worked on with a special emphasis on diversity in terms of the diversity of projects and the actors and directors and all sorts of people that have worked in the state. And also a little bit about the various projects we worked on in the past few years, both large and small productions. Let me try reloading this, sorry.
I think we just tested it before, so of course it worked then.
Yeah. Okay. One more time, and this doesn't work. Oh.
While we're waiting, can you tell me what's currently in production, or is that later later part of the program?
So currently right now we're working on a couple different projects. The big one, of course, is the Equalizer. Oh, here we go.
I'll never let this feeling go. This love has no ceiling. I cannot deny. I just want to be able to make a difference. Y'all play like this. Y'all need to play like this.
All right. So, as I said, that was a little something that I put together just to sort of introduce the Film Commission and things that we worked on show that what we do spans from the entire state, from Sussex County all the way down to Salem County. We promote the entire state of New Jersey, and we try and bring as many big productions here and small productions to New Jersey as we can. And the film industry, since the commission's inception in 1978, has contributed, I think, about $4 billion to the New Jersey economy. So it's been great. But you're all here because we're here to talk about the Academy Awards. The 93rd ceremony is this Sunday at 8 p.m. on ABC. The Best Picture nominees, in order of likelihood to win, are Nomadland, Minari, Trial of Chicago 7, Promising Young Woman, The Father, Mank, Judas and the Black Messiah, and The Sound of Metal. Due to the pandemic and Hollywood choosing to delay many of the films, this year's Best Pictures nominees are very unique and pretty groundbreaking. Three of the films have main characters that are people of color. Two of them have female main characters. Riz Ahmed, who stars in The Sound of Metal, is the first Muslim actor to get a Best Actor nomination. And it's the first time in Oscars history where two women are nominated for Best Director, Chloe Zhao for Nomadland and Emerald Fennell for Promising Young Woman. And Chloe Zhao is the first Chinese woman and the first woman of color to be nominated for Best Director. So this is pretty important because, as you may remember, 6 years ago in 2015 was the big Oscar So White controversy, where there were no nominees of color in all four acting categories. So since then, the Academy has expanded from under 6,000 voters to over 9,000, with an emphasis on bringing in younger people and people from diverse backgrounds. And they're making a conscious effort to add people from underrepresented film markets around the world. So it's also very exciting for us at the Film Commission and for New Jersey as a whole, because we have quite a few connections to the state. The writers of Judas and the Black Messiah, Kenny and Keith Lucas, grew up in Newark and Irvington. Nomadland, which is also nominated for Best Adapted Screenplay, is based on a book by journalist Jessica Bruder, who grew up in Montclair. The Father is distributed by Sony Pictures Classics, whose co-president and co-founder is Tom Bernard, a Middletown resident and one of our commissioners. And of course, as I'm sure some of you recall, The Trial of Chicago 7 filmed quite a bit in New Jersey in 2019, almost the entire film here. They built a courtroom set inside an old church in Patterson. They also used one of the mansions in the East Side Park Historic District. They shot at Dino and Harry's Steakhouse in Hoboken. They filmed in Montclair. They filmed at a bar in Kearney, Newark City Hall and Military Park, and Fairleigh Dickinson University. And the film was nominated for 6 Academy Awards, Best Picture, as I mentioned. Sacha Baron Cohen is up for Best Supporting Actor. It's got Best Original Screenplay, Best Original Song, Best Cinematography, and Best Film Editing. So I'm going to share my screen one more time here. We're going to look at the trailer in case some of you haven't seen the film, which is on Netflix.
We want to underscore again that we're coming to Chicago peacefully, but whether we're given permits or not, we're coming.
We're going to Chicago to protest the Vietnam War.
And there's no place to be right now but in it.
We watched for a decade while these rebels without a job tell us how to prosecute a war. But they're going to spend their 30s in a federal facility. Real time.
People say, you know, Abby, are you concerned about an overreaction from the cops?
Holy shit. You all right?
The worst jokes are there.
Are the people ready to make opening arguments?
At the defense table.
Abby Hoffman, Jerry Rubin, Dave Dellinger, Rennie Davis, Lee Weiner, John Freund, Tom Hayden, and Bobby Seale.
These defendants had a plan, and the plan was to incite a riot.
I call this portion of the trial with friends like these.
My trial's begun without my lawyer.
The court assumes you are being represented by the Black Panther sitting behind you.
The riots were by the Chicago Police Department.
Sustained.
Nobody objected.
The jurors 6 and 11, they're with us.
Juror number 6 and juror number 11, you're dismissed from this jury.
Can you tell us why?
Because this is my courtroom.
We've dealt with jury tampering, wiretapping, a defendant that was literally gagged.
Get your hands off me!
You're the first to suggest that I have discriminated against a black man.
And then let the record show that I'm the second.
When we walked in here this morning, they were chanting that the whole world is watching.
If we leave here without saying anything about why we came in the first place, it'll be heartbreaking.
Last summer, why did you come to the convention?
To end the war.
We're giving them exactly what they want, a stage and an audience.
Now you really think there's gonna be a big audience?
Here I go!
This is what revolution looks like, real revolution. We may have to hurt somebody's feelings.
Is this prosecution politically motivated?
I'm tired of hearing you. It would be impossible for me to care any less what you are tired of.
Here I am! There will be order!
We have to find some courage now.
Now, how much is it worth you? What's your price? To call off the revolution?
When your eyes start a new day is dawning, the new day is dawning.
So if you guys haven't seen it, I highly encourage you to check it out. It's a really wonderful movie. I was not, obviously I was born in 1986, so a bit before the history that was portrayed there. I'm familiar with all the riots in 1968 and 1967 in Newark, but wasn't familiar with that story in particular. So Aaron Sorkin is of course known for playing a little fast and loose with history, but it was still a very entertaining watch. So, and obviously as well, in last year, with everything going on in the protests for George Floyd and Black Lives Matter, it was a very timely film. Even though the film was made in 2019, it of course drew on the protests and other police shootings and Black Lives Matter stuff going on over the past 7 or 8 years. So this is pretty significant. That Trial of Chicago 7 broke into the Best Picture race because since Governor Murphy signed the Garden State Film and Digital Media Jobs Act in 2018, there have been two Academy Award ceremonies in a row where one or more movies made in New Jersey have been nominated for Best Picture. 2019, we saw The Irishman and Joker were both nominated for Best Picture. They did lose to Parasite, but they had a pretty good showing. The Irishman, as you may remember, starred Robert De Niro, Joe Pesci, and Al Pacino. It was directed by Martin Scorsese, and it filmed in Patterson and at Northern State Prison in Newark and East Jersey State Prison in Woodbridge. It was nominated for 10 Academy Awards, and I don't think it won any. Joker, filmed in Newark and Jersey City, the second time that Newark has played for Gotham City, including The Dark Knight Rises back in 2011. It was nominated for 11 Academy Awards, won Best Performance by an Actor for Joaquin Phoenix and Best Original Score. And they filmed, both of them filmed quite significantly in the state. Joker obviously was one of the first tax credit projects that we worked on. The Irishman was prior to that. But because Governor Murphy signed that tax credit program, Joker was here and was able to shoot so extensively in the state and contribute millions upon billions of dollars to the economy, the local economies in Newark and Jersey City. And prior to that, the last picture nominee that shot in New Jersey was The Wolf of Wall Street in 2013, which shot up in Closter for a couple days. That was Martin Scorsese's film starring Leonardo DiCaprio about Jordan Belfort, the guy who was bilking a lot of people out of their money back in the 80s and 90s. So that film lost to 12 Years a Slave, but was nominated for 5 Academy Awards. And it was pretty exciting for us at the time that it made it into the Best Picture race, and then everything was quiet for about 5 or 6 years. So we're hoping this becomes a trend where every year we have a film that shot a significant portion of New Jersey well represented in the Academy Awards, and that would show that that Hollywood is coming back to Jersey. And I say back to Jersey because, as I'm sure many of you know, the motion pictures date back to Thomas Edison in 1890, Thomas Edison and his assistant William Dixon created the kinetoscope, which was the first motion picture camera. And they built a studio in 1893 in West Orange called the Black Maria, which still exists, where it was a small thing that could turn to cast the sunlight during the day so that they can film throughout the entire day. By 1894, Edison was holding public screenings of films that he made in New York City. And then after that, the motion pictures went from a curio that would be shown at, you know, like festivals and things like that, to a full-fledged industry, probably around when The Great Train Robbery, which was filmed in Fort Lee, came out. It's 1903. It's a 12-minute film, and it was one of the films to pioneer cross-cutting, just having actions that are happening in different places kind of converge together, which is still, it's become part of the language of cinema, and it's still in use today. That films all the time use that in order to kind of get across their ideas and build tension. So by 1909, we had independent film studios opening up in Fort Lee, and Fort Lee became just this huge center of filmmaking, pretty much the Hollywood before Hollywood. Unfortunately, by 1917, California, people started to move out there because of the better weather and the sunshine was more consistent. And of course, Thomas Edison was going after everyone because of his patents on motion picture cameras, and he wanted to get his cut. So, but you really can't understate the impact that New Jersey had, and specifically Fort Lee. I mean, people that pioneered the art of cinema all got their start here. D.W. Griffith, Mary Pickford, Lillian Gish, Max Sennett, Lionel Barrymore, Oscar Micheaux, even the Marx Brothers had a film that they did in Fort Lee in the early 20s. And famous studios still in existence today got their start in Fort Lee. Fox Film Corporation is now 20th Century Studios. Metro Pictures Corporation and Goldwyn Pictures Corporation merged to become Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer, MGM. And Universal Film Manufacturing Company is now Universal Pictures. The first Academy Award ceremony was held in 1929. The first Best Picture winner was William A. Wellman's Wings. It's a lot of W's, got more coming. A World War I set film starring Clara Bow and a 25-year-old Gary Cooper. The film wasn't officially called the Oscars until 1939. There's some dispute as to where that name came from. Some claim that it's named after a specific person, Betty Davis's first husband, I guess, or the Academy's executive secretary's cousin, while others claim that it was a nickname for the statue that stuck. The first time that anyone publicly during the ceremony called it the Oscars was Walt Disney, and he thanked the Academy for his Oscar in 1934. Besides the films that I mentioned before with NJ Connections, we've had quite a few Best Picture winners. On the Waterfront, starring Marlon Brando and Eva Marie Saint, won in 1954. He was nominated for 12 total Academy Awards and won 8, including Best Director for L.A. Kazan, and Best Actor for Marlon Brando and Best Supporting Actress for Eva Marie Saint. The Godfather, of course, shot in Jersey City and Liberty State Park in 1973. Won Best Picture, Best Actor for Marlon Brando again, and Best Adapted Screenplay for Mario Puzo and Francis Ford Coppola. Then there was A Beautiful Mind, which sat quite significantly in the state. Bayonne, Belleville, East Orange, Jersey City, Fairleigh Dickinson University, Newark, and Princeton University. And that was in 2002. It won 4 Academy Awards, Best Picture, Best Director for Ron Howard, Best Adapted Screenplay, and Jennifer Connelly won Best Supporting Actress. So the question is Trial of the Chicago 7 going to join those films, which a lot of pundits are saying is unlikely, but you never know, or will it join the host of many other Best Picture nominees that shot in the state, like Atlantic City, Working Girl, Goodfellas, that one is still upsetting that it lost out to Dances with Wolves, Prince of Tides, Scent of a Woman, Quiz Show, As Good as It Gets, Michael Clayton. And And also, we've had quite a few Oscar-nominated directors and actors from New Jersey. One True Thing was filmed in Maplewood. Yeah, that's right. Mm-hmm. I think that one was before my time as well. So Damien Chazelle, who you may remember for, he broke out with the film Whiplash a few years ago. He was nominated for writing Whiplash, and he won Best Director for La La Land. I think that was in 2015. He grew up in Princeton, and apparently he based Whiplash off of his experiences in Princeton. Sure, yes, I can do that. Steven Spielberg, you guys all know him. He lived in Haddon Township from 1952 to 1957. I mean, wasn't a very long time, and he was six when he moved away, but still, he lived here for a little while. John Travolta, he has never won an Oscar, but he's been nominated for Best Actor for Saturday Night Fever and Pulp Fiction. And Danny DeVito has never been, only Academy Award connection is for producing Erin Brockovich, but he's never won Best Actor or been nominated, which is too bad. Of course, we've had quite a few other Best Actor winners from New Jersey, Frank Sinatra, Rod Steiger, Jack Nicholson, Meryl Streep, Michael Douglas, Joe Pesci, Susan Sarandon, and Anne Hathaway. So, quite a bit of talent from New Jersey, and people that have either grew up in the state, lived in the state, or worked in the state that have made major contributions to cinema as an art form and television as well. So, you know, New Jersey is just kind of this breeding ground for these amazing artists and these amazing works that, you know, we still celebrate and watch to this day. What we're hoping that we're going to see, as I mentioned earlier, is that the Best Picture nominees are going to continue. Every year we'll have something that's shot in the state. So, oh, yeah, thank you, Ed Harrison, yep. Mm-hmm. Steven Spielberg's remake of West Side Story was supposed to open last year, but obviously we're still living with the reason why it's not open. And it is supposed to come out this year on December 10th. That film in Patterson and Newark, also in 2019. And the Sopranos film, The Many Saints of Newark, is going to premiere in theaters and on HBO Max on September 24th. So, and that filmed in Jersey City, Hasbrook Heights, at Holston's in Bloomfield, quite significantly in Newark, Passaic, and Patterson in 2019 and 2020. So that's sort of my Oscars rundown. In terms of filming in New Jersey, I mean, one of the things that's been great and one of the things that I've learned over the past almost a decade is that every town does something a little bit differently. So Union does not have its own film permits or anything like that, but neighboring towns like Millburn and Maplewood, they do. So one of our jobs at the Film Commission is to kind of untangle all that stuff and to help production companies working in the state for how best to get permission for the locations that they need. And if things are going to be too difficult or too expensive, how can we redirect them to a similar location, which will make it a little bit easier and a more budget friendly for them in order to shoot. So that's a major part of what I do as production coordinator. We also liaison with the individual towns so that we'll speak to them about their ordinances and their rules and restrictions and, you know, work with them to make sure that they're being as film friendly as possible. And so that they're bringing in, because this is a major, as I said, Chicago 7 brought in millions of dollars, Joker, millions of dollars. We don't have the final figures yet, but we are waiting for them to come in. The contributions are immense, and we're talking everything from lumber yards to coffee shops, to catering companies, to truck rentals, to gas stations. This is all, you know, money that's going into just, you know, everyday shops, local shops, local people, as well as location fees for people using and renting out their homes or their businesses or anything like that. And the money that goes to the town for county parks and municipal parks is also, you know, used to kind of help, you know, beautify everything and make sure that everyone's got, everything that they need. So I guess I'll open it up to questions now.
Okay, so I'm just going to make a few comments. Somebody asked if it's possible Steven Spielberg went to Brookdale Community College.
You know, I don't know. I'd have to look into, is there a reason why that he might have gone there?
Because he was born there, I believe.
I mean, I thought it was in Haddon Township in South Jersey, in Camden County.
Okay, Ethan Hawke has also made movies here, right?
Mm-hmm, yeah.
And I'm going to ask Nate to unmute himself. Nate has quite a few questions.
Great.
So Nate, I've got to find you. Hold on. And And if somebody else wants to ask their own question, just put your name in the box in chat and I will unmute you. So Nat, are you there?
Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah,
yeah. Perfect.
Oh, thank you. Thank goodness. Oh, my goodness. I couldn't get the video to work, so I can't. My face isn't up there, I'm sure. So it just says Nate, right?
It's like an eye with crown over top of it. It's pretty cool.
Oh, thank you. That's good enough. That's good enough. All right. That's my film company. I have a small film company that I'm running out of my mom's house.
Nice.
Right in Union. And we won a couple of awards over the years.
Great.
And I was kind of curious about how do you find, that's actually two questions. How do you find actors for bit parts? Because I use backstage.com and I've gotten the big roles filled. Mm-hmm. And I've also gone to King University and I've gotten some actors from King University, but all these smaller parts where there's like no hardly any talking or anything like that, I haven't been able to find actors for those parts. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you don't want to use unskilled, you know what I'm saying? And it's an on-paying gig, so.
Right. Well, so there's a couple ways to go about it. I guess because it's on-paying, the way that I would usually say is that we have on our website, it's called the Production Services Directory. Our website is film.nj.gov. And then under, there's a drop-down that says Production Tools, and the Production Services Directory is there. And that's a listing of all companies, and you should register yourself on there as well, companies that work in or for the film industry in the state. So we have everything on there from crew positions to animal trainers to hotels to insurance companies, lawyers, and we also have casting agencies. I'm not sure if it's unpaid, if the casting agencies will be able to help you there, but the other thing you can do is if you send us a bulletin, we can post it on our bulletin board that you're seeking extras. Is there some sort of incentive?
We're giving them IMDb credits, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So yeah, right. Plus we're hitting all the major film festivals like Tribeca, Sundance, and Slamdance, and Cinequest, and so forth like that, you know? So. Right. Yeah, so it's like I really am looking to get more exposure for my actors. Mm-hmm. And plus I'm also on tailflick.com. So, and they've been even like, you know, sort of, you know, being quiet about how well the script is doing, but it's going in front of a lot of producers right now, and it might get options. So,
oh, great. Are you planning a film in Jersey?
Yeah, I'm planning on filming in June and July. I'm going to do a test pilot. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to take every Friday in June and July and just do, because the short film, and I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to film as much as I can, the best way I can, even though the script calls for bigger action, you know what I'm saying? We'll just rewrite it along the way.
Mm-hmm,
Yeah. And I was kind of concerned because how do you find funding? Like, I have a GoFundMe page, right?
Mm-hmm.
But it's just not picking up a lot of steam, and I've been hitting everybody on Twitter and everything like that, you know what I'm saying? It just hasn't picked up enough steam, you know? So I was wondering where you get funding from for your short films.
Yeah, funding, that's a tough one. I think that the way you're going about it is probably, I haven't had as much experience with that side of it. So I know GoFundMe and Indiegogo, they were hugely popular about 5 or 6 years ago, but I had heard from some student filmmakers we work with that they were having some difficulty getting their films funded that way as well. I wish I had a better answer for you for that. I guess try to publicize it as best you can, make sure that people kind of understand your vision. You know, I'm sure that you have it on there, what the funds are going to be used for and all that stuff, so.
Nate, when you do have your film done, you'll have to come speak at Union Library. And maybe there are some extras here in our audience tonight who be involved. So if you put it in chat, I will share the information. Can you talk about The Soprano?
Sure. So that was before my time as well. But they did shoot the almost the entire series here. I actually just went through, it was another one of my pandemic projects. I've been going through our files and just kind of updating everything. We were missing little pieces here and there. Because we've had interns bring in all of our paper files and digitize stuff over the years. And there's a great website called sopranos-locations.com. I think that's the name of it. And they went through every season, every episode, like pretty much every moment, and broke down exactly where the locations were. And it was pretty interesting to see. And they had screenshots of them, and they would compare it with Google Maps. And obviously, Tony Soprano's house was in North Caldwell. Satrialis was in, it was Kearney. And it's gone now. I want to say Harrison, but I think it's Kearney. They tore it down. But they filmed significantly in Essex County, Essex County, Hudson, Passaic. There was all that at the Fountains of Wayne and up in Wayne in the second season where Tony Soprano was going there and meeting up with one of his side pieces. That place was great. I missed that one. That's it. Yeah. Sopranoslocations.com. So yeah, I mean, I wish I was there at the time. There is a pretty funny story. One of my favorites actually that my executive director and associate director always talk about. In the first season, there's a scene where somebody gets murdered and thrown off of the Great Falls in Patterson. So when they shot the scene, they used a dummy and they threw it off the Great Falls for the scene. And I'm sure if some of you have been up there, it's like an absolutely stunning waterfall. And there's just so much water that goes through there. So the dummy got sucked underneath the falls and didn't come up and just like lost in the rocks. And so the production company was sort of like, okay, I guess it's fine. So they left. It was, I think like a couple months later, don't quote me on this. I think it was a July 4th celebration. The entire city of Patterson was gathered at the Great Falls, and you know they were doing this whole like citywide celebration. And the dummy decided it's going to take that moment to surface, and so now it looks like a dead body floating in the Great Falls behind this like citywide ceremony. I just think it's pretty funny. So yeah, and then obviously the last scene was in Holston's in Bloomfield, and they went back to Holston's, as I mentioned, for The Many Saints of Newark, which stars Tony Soprano's, the actor's, James Gandolfini's son plays young Tony Soprano in that film. And pretty cool for us to have him go back to Holston's, which is, I guess, hasn't changed in years and years. I used to get ice cream there when I was little. My grandfather lived around the corner.
I'm going to open this up. I'm going to ask you all to unmute if you want to. I'm going to ask you all to unmute if you want to ask a question. And there's lots of comments in chat about individual movies, and it seems like a lot of people have experiences. I don't know if Ava's still here, who I think Ava said she had a film done in her parents' house. Ava, did you have a film in your parents' house that you want to share this information about? And the answer can be no. Okay. Mm-hmm. How do you decide, why would you say no to a TV or movie or a commercial or anybody being filmed here? Is there anything that you would consider to graphic or content? And then we're going to go to Alicia right after that.
We do not censor content. Obviously, that it has to, for in order to use our services, it can't be pornography. But anything else that we don't, as state government officials, we can't be like, no, you can't shoot this here. However, there have of course been instances where individual towns have expressed some reticence to permit certain films that have had questionable content. One of the big things that we were doing prior to the tax credit, I don't know if any of you watched the Discovery ID channel and their whole slate of shows, which are all the serial killer docudramas with the really clever names like Young, Hot, and Crooked, and I Killed My BFF, and Deadly Women, and things like that. There are all these films about real life crimes, and they'll interview the victims, and they'll stage reenactments. And for whatever reason, they love shooting the reenactments in New Jersey. There were some instances, though, where they were covering a high profile crime that happened in the state, and the individual town where that crime took place was not too excited about having a reenactment shot there to kind of dredge up, negative connotations. So we as a film commission, you know, we try and help them find some place that would, you know, be a little more amenable to shooting that. But yeah, it's, you know, we worked on a variety of films from, you know, very sweet comedies to some pretty hardcore horror films. So, you know, we accept everybody.
Hi, can you talk about the financial arrangements when they pick a location, get the permits, or their royalties, bidding rights? How does the financing work?
You're talking about on the film company side?
The film company and the town.
The town, I don't believe, probably not the best person to ask about royalties, but I've never heard it come up before. So I don't believe that, because I don't think there's that many locations in the state that are copyrighted. I know the Colgate clock is, so they might get royalties, but I'm not sure. But I don't think that there's any sort of in perpetuity money coming to the towns that shot in a particular, coming to the towns for a film that shot in their locale. And the same with homeowners and businesses. I don't believe that that's, I can't recall hearing about that. Doesn't mean it doesn't exist, but I don't think so.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, no problem.
Alicia, are you there? Did you have a question?
Hi, I don't know if you can hear me. Sorry, kind of was an error. But I wanted to say this is very informative. Thank you very much. And I did just have a message for Nate. I just sent him a direct message just to kind of give him some heads up. I don't know if you can hear
Nate,
me.
Check your chat because Alicia's going to help you one way or another. Do you know about ABC's Emergent, filmed in Nutley?
Yes. Yes, it did shoot in Nutley. It shot, I was actually in the video. I saw someone ask about that as well, where they can find it online. I think I can post it onto our YouTube page. So I will do that so that you guys can see it there. Emergence did. It shot all over the state. They were based in, I think their studio was in Kearney, I'm pretty sure. And they shot a lot of the pilot in Island Beach State Park. That's where the plane crashed and they found the little girl and all that stuff. And they also shot at the Westfield police station and in Montclair. Montclair stood in for the beach town on Long Island. They used special effects to bring in the lighthouse, the Barnegat Lighthouse in the background.
Do you know where the waterfront was filmed?
Yes. Where specifically in Hoboken?
I guess so.
I think it was at, oh, it's been so long since I saw it.
Anybody else can feel free to chime in.
Yeah, if anybody else knows, I can look it up. Hang on a second. I should have been prepared for that. I think it was in Sinatra Park and let's see, hang on a second. Bear with me. Okay, so I'm seeing here the Fifth Street Pier, Elysian Park, Court Street in Hoboken, the Hoboken train station, Hudson Street, Our Lady of Grace Church on Willow Avenue, the St. Peter and St. Paul Church on Hudson Street, Stevens Park, and then also on Willow Avenue. They filmed, according to IMDb, which hopefully is correct, they filmed from November 1953 to January 1954. It's probably about correct.
So here's a real softball question. Why did anybody film in New Jersey?
Better parking than in New York City, first of all. there is the great cooperation in the state. You can find anything that you need within a 2-hour drive. We have mountains, we have swamps, we have beaches, we have mansions and chateaus. We have tight urban neighborhoods. We have like lovely suburbs, forests, and it's all in this very tight, compact area. That's been one of the things that I've most enjoyed about this job. When I first got it, they would send me out to photograph throughout the state. So I went down to the rodeo in Piles Grove, Salem County. I went to Cape May, took photos there. The Great Swamp, up to the Skylands region, hiked in the mountains for the Hunger Games, the second Hunger Games film. So.
Good.
Yeah.
Anyone else have any questions? What's being filmed right now? Can you tell us a little bit?
Yeah. So right now there's a show on Hulu. It's in its second season. It's about the rap group, the pioneering rap group called the Wu-Tang Clan. The show is called Wu-Tang and American Saga. They're filming all over the state. The Equalizer is filming here with Queen Latifah. Is Janice Kovach in here? Hi, Janice. That's one of our commissioners. She's also the mayor of Clinton.
Hello.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, good. Thanks for joining us.
Glad I could.
Yeah, I caught us at the tail end here. They're asking about stuff currently filming in the state. So I was just giving the rundown. The Equalizer has been filming with Queen Latifah. That just got renewed for its second season, which is pretty exciting for us. We've had a couple shows. They mentioned Emergence, The Enemy Within, and Lincoln Rhyme, Hunt for the Bone Collector, that were all on either ABC or NBC. It unfortunately got canceled after their first season. So to have The Equalizer be renewed has been really exciting for us.
Well, she's a Jersey girl, right?
She is, yes. She grew up in
Newark or Irvington?
Irvington, yeah, it was one or the other. So I think let me just double check what I can talk about here, if you bear with me for a second.
Does anyone have a favorite TV or movie that they filmed in New Jersey that they want to share?
The Wrestler.
Oh, that was a great one.
Yeah, so that was Elizabeth and Rahway, Rahway Hospital, I know, because my mom worked there. They weren't there when she was working, but they worked at her hospital.
Oh, cool. Wow. Yeah, I love the Asbury Park scenes and everything. I saw that one in the theaters.
Yeah, that was from Marissa Tomei. It was a great movie.
Mm-hmm.
She was Queen Latifah, was born in Newark.
In Newark, yeah.
Do you know anything about a Patrick Dempsey movie being filmed in Trenton?
Yes. That's a TV show. It's called Ways and Means. And I believe they're done filming now. But yeah, they shot in Trenton at the, takes place in DC. He plays a conservative lawmaker who partners with a young liberal lawmaker to kind of push through the stagnation in Congress and get things done. So Trenton stood in for Washington, D.C., which if you guys have been down there, which I'm sure you have, it's pretty similar architecture in some spots. So that was great for the city, especially because we're seeing more films kind of push out of the immediate New York City area and explore more of the state now that we've had the tax incentive for a couple years. People are starting to look further. We had it's a film coming out soon on Netflix. It's called Army of the Dead. It's Zack Snyder, who did the most recent Justice League film. It's a zombie movie, but also a heist movie set in Las Vegas. And they shot significantly in Atlantic City at the Showboat and the Atlantic Club. Oh, Garden State, of course, and Friday the 13th, one of my favorites. Mm-hmm.
Amy, can you share your information?
Yeah, two things. There's a film, independent film a few years back called Two Pints Lighter. I put the IMDb reference in the chat. It's a romantic sort of tragedy about a young vampire who he kind of wakes up in Asbury Park, and it's filmed in the bowling alley there, most of it. So that's pretty fun.
Oh, cool.
And I first saw it at the Montclair Film Festival a couple years ago, and the filmmakers were in attendance, and then they came back a few years later with a short film that was there also. Can you talk a little bit about film festivals, like Asbury Park one and New Jersey one and the Montclair Film Festival?
Sure, yeah, I actually volunteered at the Montclair Film Festival a couple years in a row. It was a fantastic experience. I mean, that's such a prestigious film festival. I missed Patrick Wilson a couple times. Apparently I was working the door and somehow he slipped through. I have no idea. Apparently he keeps to himself quite a bit.
He's always at all the events though.
Yeah, I know, I think it's great. People see him walking around Montclair and everything. That one's great. And I had the opportunity to see Stephen Colbert's wife speak at one of the events. And I got very close to Stephen as well. He's quite tall. Accidentally did not let his son back into the VIP area because he was trying to get in. And I was like, no, you can't come in. I'm sorry. And then Stephen had to tap me on the shoulder and said, he's allowed.
Can I ask a follow-up question about the Bellevue movie theater and also now the Claridge in Montclair on Bloomfield Avenue. I can't believe that shut down now, because I mean, it was doing so great and then COVID came along. So what are the current plans for that site and for the Bellevue?
Yeah, you know, that's a great question.
Trying to develop.
We're not too involved with the distribution end of it. So I'm not exactly sure what's going to happen with those. I certainly hope that someone will revive them. I used to live in Bloomfield for a couple of years and then would go up to the Claridge and the Bellevue all the time. They were great. So yeah, definitely very sad whenever the theaters close. I live in Clark now, and the Cranford Theater is, they're staying alive because of the drive-ins, and I would just be devastated if they close down again. So yeah, I don't know. I hope that either the Montclair Film Festival is able to utilize that space still, or you know, they can keep it as a running theater. That'd be great. And then I should mention, you talked about film festivals. The Garden State Film Festival is fantastic. The Black Mariah Film Festival, my executive director is on the board of, and I've never been to it myself, but apparently there's some short filmmakers there that are, you know, absolutely stunning. And the films they're putting together are, you know, really interestingly pushing the art form in new ways. We have so many. There's the, yeah, the Asbury Park Music and Film Festival, which I know Tom Bernard, who I mentioned before, our commissioner, is a big booster of, because he lives in Middletown. So yeah, I mean, it's great, and it's great to have this home for all these independent films and stuff that's shot in Jersey. And they have the young filmmaker stuff from, you know, the students show their films off. Yes, that's right. I also do, I work with my executive director, who's on the board of the Rutgers Jewish Film Festival. We produce a trailer for them every year. Oh, I did see something about the Cranford Film Festival. Yeah, I saw something about it. I don't know if they reached out to our office. I'm not sure.
And Debbie Burke also points out New Jersey Film Festival, New Jersey Jewish Film Festival at Rutgers, I think, mm-hmm. and the South Orange Maplewood Film Festival.
Oh, yes, right.
So Joe, how do we get your job? I know you started out as a production assistant. How did you get your first job there, and then how did you get into the commission?
So I went to George Washington University for undergrad from 2004 to 2008. I majored in philosophy and minored in film theory. Obviously, when I graduated, this cataclysmic event happened called the Great Recession. It wasn't very useful to have a philosophy degree. So I went straight to film school. I went out to Los Angeles, where I always wanted to go, and went to Loyola Marymount University, which is a smaller school at the time, but is now kind of gaining in name recognition, catching up to USC and UCLA, you know, the bigs out there. So that was a 3-year program, and it was fantastic, but you can't get good Italian food out there. So I had to come back to Jersey. When I came back here, I had jobs in New York, production assistant jobs. I worked on a couple music videos and commercials and things like that. And really just kind of the right place at the right time, was able to get my resume in front of the right eyes. And the Film Commission had an opening for, I think, I'm not sure how long it was, but they were looking for an assistant production coordinator. And I was able to get started. I was supposed to start right when The Dark Knight Rises was filming, but it got held up. So I didn't start until February 2012. So the first major feature I worked on was the second Hunger Games film. They called our office at like the end of November, and the director, I guess, grew up in Northern or in the Round Pole Mountains region. I'm not sure if it was in New York or in New Jersey, and really wanted that for the beginning of the film. So I went up through the mountains and scouted around there for, I just took my camera and my hiking boots and just took photos of all the trails. I actually just posted a bunch of them on our website this morning. And they ended up filming there in January for 2 days. So that was very exciting for me to, you know, the first project, major project I worked on start to finish. And in the pre-tax credit era as well, when, you know, a lot of productions were staying in New York or Georgia or Canada, because it was made more financial sense for them to shoot their films entirely there because of the tax incentive they would get back.
Can you talk at all whether your office does anything for researchers or anybody here who's listening, if they have questions about film? Do you have a consumer front or services at all?
Yeah, I mean, we'd be happy to work with anybody who has any sort of questions. Our records date back to my executive director has sort of made it. He's been with the commission for, since like 1982. And he looks at our files as an historical record. So if there's any questions about, you know, things that have shot in New Jersey, we can look anything up for anybody.
That's good. Do you work at all with universities and colleges? I know you mentioned Princeton and FDU.
Yes. So in terms of universities that allow filming, or in terms of getting students from them, or working with student filmmakers, or both?
Just in general, do the schools come to you and ask you for, you know, the intern there, or is there any relationship?
Yeah, we've had, so obviously our intern program is, on ice right now during the pandemic. We haven't quite figured out how to do it virtually yet, although I think that they are working on that. But prior to that, we had interns from all sorts of schools. Our requirements were either they had to be attending a university within New Jersey, or they had to be New Jersey residents who were attending university outside the state. So we had quite a few interns from Bloomfield College and Montclair State University, I think Fairleigh Dickinson, Brookdale Community College, couple, I think we had one from Rowan. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. So yeah, and then in terms of universities allowing filming, we're finding that a lot of them are reaching out to us. They're conference and event services. They have all sorts of spaces that they want to use. Kane University was huge. They have all of those very modern buildings on the campus that people love. Montclair State University has beautiful views of New York City and all of that Spanish architecture. Which is, you know, great for people that are looking to set something in California or in Europe. And then Bloomfield College as well, they had contacted us a couple years ago. We photographed the college, and they have a nursing program. And hospitals are one of our most difficult locations to find, because I guess other states have a lot of closed hospitals that are available for filming, but I guess this is a plus for New Jersey. We have none. All of our hospitals are currently in use. So it's difficult for filmmakers to find hospital settings. And a lot of them were going, actually so many were going to Bloomfield College to use their nursing program that the college kind of said like, okay, we need to take a step back because there is a pandemic raging right now. Yes, Big filmed in Bergen County. I want to say, is it Cliffside Park? Yeah, that was another famous one. We have that poster on our wall in the office.
A big shout out to Kane University for being in union and so many unions.
Mm-hmm.
And speaking of union, Union Public Library is really thrilled to present programs like this, and we are doing all kinds of interesting programs. If you want to find out what's happening at the library, and I'll post it in here, there are three ways, and anybody who's Maria and Ethelyn probably have memorized these along with me. You can go to our website, you can sign up for our newsletter, and you can like us on Facebook. And the other thing I want to emphasize is that if you live, work, or go to school in Union, you can get a library card, and you can get movies, digital movies, all sorts of things with your library card. So we really encourage you to do that. And can you talk at all about any TV going on now or commercials? Is the process different for TV, movies, and commercials?
Well, TV, the TV and movies are, they present their own challenges, but one of the nice things about them is they typically give us quite a bit of advance notice. I think when Joker filmed in Newark, they had contacted us. They filmed in September, and they had contacted us way back in March of that year. So, you know, a lot of time, and they closed down Market Street. They had all these period cars. They had to remake the facade of all the facades of all those buildings there. That kind of thing is a little bit easier because there's enough time to bring everybody from the city, and any sort of state and municipal, and NJ Transit was involved because of rerouting the bus lines. So that makes things easier. Commercials can be a bit of a different animal because typically there's a quicker turnaround time. We may get anywhere from 3 days notice to a couple weeks. And some, as I mentioned, each town in New Jersey has a different permitting rules and restrictions. So some towns require more time to approve a permit than others, which can make it difficult for a commercial that's looking to shoot in the state. But we've done some incredible ones. One of the ones that was in that video montage I showed earlier was the guy pushing the car off of the cliff that was shot in the Bellmead Quarry down in Hillsborough. And that was a Super Bowl commercial. We've done Oscar commercials, Emmy commercials, major stars, Tom Brady, Kevin Spacey. So yeah, and then obviously a lot of smaller stuff, things that run on, local things and, funny, clever things. So it's always interesting.
I was curious how many cars they had to shove off there before they got it right.
Yeah, I know.
So Amy is asking, anything filmed in Essex County Recreational Area or South Mountain Reservoir?
Yes. So South Mountain has some great looks because it's probably the closest mountain to New York City. And it's got Hemlock Falls, which is wonderful. I'm trying to think of something that filmed there most recently. You put me on the spot. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to come up with it.
If you have an answer, I'm going to send a follow-up email to everyone. And in the email, I can put the answer.
I can. Yes, that would be great. Yeah, give me some time to look into that. But, that whole area, West Orange, Milburn, Maplewood is very popular for filming. We have people filming in that area all the time. Montclair especially, they do about anywhere from 70 to over 100 projects per year.
Right. I think we're about wrapping up here, unless somebody else has another question.
Oh, yeah. So I was there for when they filmed in Cranford, actually. My parents live right around the corner from where the Track 5 Coffee is and the under there. That was really cool.
Which one are you talking about?
Oh, sorry. The Plot Against America, I should have said. Which was also a great series. If anyone hasn't seen that yet, I highly recommend they check it out. It was very, very gripping and thrilling.
Back
and finally.
Well, of course, if it's made in New Jersey, it has to be good, right?
Yeah, that's right. Exactly.
So I want to thank everybody tonight for participating and remind you to look in chat and see the three ways to find out about programs and events and resources at Union Public Library. And Joe, we pulled it off, huh?
We sure did. Thank you all so much for joining us. I hope that you had fun. I certainly did. This was great.
Very interesting. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.